that up. So consideration of the comprehensive website redesign.
Last year you'd approved money in the capital budget for us to update our website so that it can be more user friendly. And we went through the request for proposal process. So we, you know, sent it out to have people submit their proposals to us, and we interviewed two finalists, and we selected Pavlov to redesign the website. They're experienced with transit and trip planners, and the fact that they would be the best option for us in our community here. Where the cost was significantly higher than what we anticipated, so we want to split it into two phases, having phase one complete this year with the money that we already had planned and set aside, and then have phase two happen in the next fiscal year. And so we're looking for approval to move forward with that, to be able to award the project to Pavlov in this two-phase agreement, so that we can have a trip planner, basically rebuild our website from bottom up with, to make it a lot easier to use. We get a lot of feedback from people where they like, hey, Hazel and other people can't find this or can't find that. And so it will also include a little bit of a usability test to make sure that everything is placed in the right spot. And we'll have training videos on there to help people learn how to ride the bus, especially important with us wanting to increase ridership. We want to have our website be user-friendly and welcoming and not a barrier for people to ride our system. So that's what I'm looking at here. And if you see at the bottom, it says with the understanding that the second phase of the project will be brought back to the commission with the 2017 to 2021 capital improvement plan. So, do you have any questions for me?
Why was the price so high?
Well, the trip planner costs a lot more than we thought it would, and this also includes the videos and the new photography. The video and photography portion of it, well, video is kind of expensive to do. And then the photography, we are looking at getting the photography that can be used not only for the website, but on all of our brochures, all of our marketing things, so that we can make it be a consistent brand throughout and be not just a quality that can be used on the website, but also used everywhere, having all the rights to use those photographs. And it just costs more than we realize to redo your website from the ground up with a new content management system.
One of the things that I think I heard you say is that this resolution was us agreeing to enter a contract
to have like two phases.
So we're not.
You're not agreeing
to the second phase.
Right. Okay. You're saying my understanding. Call it. Yeah. So it's saying, yep. You can have this. You can get started on the website. You can do phase one, and then you have the understanding that the website won't be as polished or whatever until phase two is done.
Okay.
And so you guys have to approve that later when you're going through the budget.
And then when we do phase one with the website, will it be, well, backing up when I said to my husband, I have to figure out how to ride the bus tomorrow, he said, well, just download their app. And I...
We'll have the trip planner. It won't be as, it'll be a very basic trip planner, which is better than what we have today, which is no trip planner. After phase two, it would be a little smoother to use because part of phase two will be those final touches on the graphic design of it,
okay.
To make sure it's very easy to use.
Will the new design be smartphone, like for instance, I tried to find Route 32 and every time I touched on Route 32 on my smartphone, it came up Route 31.
Yeah.
And I had to figure it out.
So currently today we have our regular website and then we have a mobile website and they look very different from each other. And so if someone goes to the mobile website, you don't see our landing page, you don't just see the news, you just see the routes and a note for detours. And with the new design, it'll be, where it changes to whatever device you have. There's a name for that. I cannot think of it. I cannot think of it, but there's a word for it.
We're already beyond what we're implementing anyway.
So anyways, yes, it's going to work on a smartphone and a tablet and the desktop and all look, it'll change the size to work on all those platforms, but it won't be a completely different site like it is now.
Okay, thank you.
The whole goal is to enhance the user experience, to make it easier to find the information, to make it easier to want to ride the bus.
Great. Two questions. It's $50,000 this year, I take it.
Mm-hmm.
And did you have locked in for the price then for the next phase?
For the next phase, we had put in the additional $50,000.
That'll cover it?
That will cover it.
Okay. And then timing, maybe I missed it. What's timing-wise for the first phase?
For the first phase, we want to have it done so that when we have, if it's, the new routes are approved, that we'll be able to launch at the same time. And then the second phase would then, we would start working on that right away so that we would be able to finish it hopefully by the end of November.
Thanks.
If approved. Ooh. Any other questions?
So, I'm sorry, I missed the first part about the app. The app would be available?
It's a trip planner that's on our website, so you'd be able to access it from your smartphone or from a tablet or from the desktop. And in phase one, it'd be a very basic version of the trip planner. And
You're not creating an app all by itself.
It's not an app all by itself.
Has that been explored as potentially something?
Part of our technology package that we are looking at doing moving forward.
Yeah, when we have like real time data and all that availability, then that makes sense.
I learned today at the Rider Advisory Committee meeting that that you can get something that isn't an app, that it's not an app, but it's gonna be like an app, but it's not an app.
It's like a bookmark on your phone, on your desk. Right. So you just hit that and it brings you right to the website.
Okay, a bookmark.
Well, I don't know if that's like official, but it's like having a thing put right up to the bookmark. It's not an app. But it acts like an app if you're hooked up to the internet.
Could you, when that process is going through it and you're ready and you're complete and ready to go, if you could reach out to, I'll speak for St. Cloud, but I'm assuming all these cities would, could you reach out to our IT folks and make sure that our, because I think all of our websites would be nice to have that. And we have an app now at St. Cloud, so we'd like to have that piece of it, though, connected to MetroBus so that that service is available all over cities. But it'd just be probably more helpful if you reached out to our folks.
Mm-hmm. I can do that.
Any other questions? All right, thank you.
And I think I need, are you going to vote?
Is this an action item?
Yeah, you have to say, you can go into that, agree to that contract.
Do this by consensus. Any other discussion? Is there a motion, first of all, to approve moving forward?
I'll make that motion.
It's been moved and seconded. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Thanks.
Thank you.